Hi folks, Larry here, Mobile Tech from CanTamTrailers.com, and today I'm coming to you from inside the 48 Mainline. And what I'm here to show you is that I've got the first sliding window installed, and I'm going to show you how we do that, how these windows, or this window system I should call it, is put together. Now this doesn't have windows like your normal trailer that just unscrew, the whole window pops out, you can clean it up, put new gaskets in it, and then pop it back in and screw it back in. Nope. This is a homemade window system. Every part in this window system has to be made pretty much by hand. And by hand, I mean, you know, lumber is milled down and sawed out, screws are installed, glass is cut, framing is put in, sill is made by hand by me on my bender and installed, and then when it all comes together it looks like this. You have a window that slides up and down, and even this is part of the window system because it hides the glass as it slides up and into and behind the cabinet. There's even a hiding piece back inside the cabinet here that had to be pre-installed. So the only thing really that I had to make myself by hand was this windowsill piece of metal down here. Everything else, except for this covering, everything else is original. I also installed new screws and these fancy washers, finishing washers that go with it. So let me show you how this window opens and closes. All right, basically, you loosen up this wing nut over here that has a little piece of new rubber on it. I put new rubber on it, it's just rubber hose. And you loosen this guy and you lift the window and then you tighten this guy down, and that puts pressure against the glass and holds the window up. Isn't that goofy? Now inside here are little felt covered rails that, just like the kind that are in the older cars on the side of the glass where the glass rolls up and down. This is exactly the same kind of material, but from 1948. Let me show you one of those. All right, here it is, and really all it is just a piece of U-shaped channel that's all felt covered, and it sits in the sides like this, and the glass slides up and down inside there. These are original. I didn't get new ones. I could have, but these are good, so why not go ahead and use them. Now to close the window, you just go ahead and loosen this wing nut over here, and the window, loosen it completely, and the window drops like that. Pretty much gravity does its job, and then you can tighten this back up. So that's how the window system works. I'm getting ready to install number two, which will be this window over here. All right, so basically it starts with the screen that goes in first, and the screen does not move, it stays stationary. So I've cleaned up the edges of it all the way around, and then here's the glass. Now this is the original glass, original pole handle. I cleaned it up the best that I can. And I just basically go ahead and mount these guys on the sides, something like that, get them even, all right? And then I go ahead and I place my screen over that like this, and this entire thing goes in together, and I'll show you how I do that because I'm doing this by myself. I have nobody to hold it for me. So what I'm going to use is a couple of putty knives and pressure in order to hang on to it while I get the covering that holds it all together, which is this covering here. And again, that's original. I just refinished it is all. So there's another one that goes over here. All right. Now, before we can even think about putting the rest of the system in, we have to put this cover in. This is what hides the glass as it slides up, and it keeps it from basically falling forward also. So basically what I've done is I've drilled holes every 8 inches here, half inch in, and I'm using these gold twisty nails. Which come looking just like this at Home Depot. They're number 15 by 7/8 long twist nails. These are built by Crown Bolt, brass plated. And you can get these at Home Depot, Lowe's, online, a lot of places. And basically I just drill pilot holes that are a little bit smaller than the nails. Tap them in like that, it's ready to go up. All right, so basically, try not to break my glass here. This guy, which was made quite a long time ago, goes up here like that. And I just have to tack it in now. So I'll tack it in lightly, because I may have to do adjustment later. I don't know, we want to make sure. We just get it nice and straight. Okay. I don't need all the nails in, just enough to keep it in place until I get ready to install the bottom piece that does the cover up. And the whole reason this has to go in first is because this has a channel in it right here. Not a channel, but it's basically a rabbeted edge, and that goes up against the bottom like that, see? So as you can see, this piece has to go in first in order to make this piece right and proper like that. So that's what we're going to do. This will go up and be held into place, and that's what holds all the window mechanism in once everything's together. And again, this is not easy to do by yourself, so a lot of fun, but I show everybody how to do everything by themselves, because a lot of cases you're by yourself, which I am right now. All right, let me get my putty knives and everything over here ready to go. I'll just put them in my pockets here, and we'll get our glass and everything ready to go, and the screen, which goes in first along with everything. So, and here we go. So we just tilt it back, tilt the whole thing in like this, and it won't fit until I get these things all the way down. Okay, and that has to go all the way down in there. Same with this one over here. Like I said, it's not easy. That pushed all the way down. And once it's all the way down, these rails, they should go in. Not wanting to real easy. A little crowded here on this side, which is why I just tacked these guys in, so they could be, so this thing could be easily removed. Okay, this side's working okay. It's this side over here that doesn't want to. So I've got to, while I'm holding everything there, get it over that. Now I can do it. Okay, now I can go ahead and tack this back in again. All I gotta do is find the hammer, just to tack it with. It's within reach here. All right. All right, that kind of holds it in temporarily. So now I can remove my putty knives. There, everything's in there now. I'm gonna give it another little tap on the top to hold everything. All right, now this guy goes up. See? Not easy. Gotta get him centered and square with everything so that he can be tacked up now temporarily until I get the screws in for that. All right, so I've got it where I want it. I'm gonna go ahead and tack it in. There we go. There, the window system is held in now. And everything's good. So I guess I can go ahead. I'm just gonna run a little test here real quick, make sure this window, yeah, it slides up and down okay. So we're good there. All right, I'm gonna be doing a little bending on this little piece down here in a bit. So now what I can do is go ahead and tack this in permanently. Oops, come on. I'll get the other ones later, but now I know it's all held up good. So now we go for our finish screws around here. Right, so what I've got is, you can see how they look over here when I'm done with it. As you can see, here and here, they look really nice when I'm done with them. So these are just brass coated wood screws. These are number 8, I believe. No, I'm sorry, number 6 by 1 inch. And they come in a package like this from True Value. And I got these cup washers, finish washers from Ace Hardware. And as you can see, it makes everything nice and flush. And it's just a really good finish look. So, and this is my bit. So now all I need is my screw gun and we're ready to go. So here we go with our first one. We'll go right down here, I think. Sucks that in real nice. Now I think we'll go straight across to the opposite one over here, which is kind of how you want to do this. Now we got 3 in the bottom. If I just get my fingers to work here. I think we'll start in the middle. This hole seems a little off from the other ones, but it's factory. It's what they did at the manufacturer. I'm just, you know, reusing their old holes. Some of these screws aren't very pointy. That one goes right here. There we go. Now, we have 4 holes left. Here, here, and there, and there. And those don't get these kind of things. Those get those gold twisty nails. So just like I put in the top part. So let me get those. All right, so we need 4 of those. I don't know why they did it like this, I just know that they did it like this. Drop one. One more, because I dropped one. I don't see it anywhere, so it disappeared. Just went into the abyss of the trailer somewhere. And you'll notice how I hold these. This is the way roofers used to hold their roofing tacks, and still do to this day, if they're doing it by hand. For one thing, it makes it easy to guide the nail, and for the other thing, if you hit your fingers like that, it doesn't hurt anywhere as much as if you hit it like that. So there we go. So while we're at it, go ahead and finish these. I'm going to have to use a finish, nail set for the one over here because it's so close to the wood. I don't want to ding it. I will get the nail set and finish that one off. It's just so close to the top of this other wood, I don't want to ding that other wood. There we go. There, she's all done except for the glass stop, which goes right here. That's what holds the window open, and I'll go grab that. All right, this thing is just, you know, a little piece of metal with a couple of holes drilled in it and that piece of rubber hose over the end of it. That's all it is. So there's two parts to this. First, this goes on here like that. All right, and the wing nut goes on it until it's tight. Get this thing straight. There we go. And there's a little hole there, and that's for a screw. Let me get the screw. It's just a little 6 by 1/2 inch pan head, is all that is. Go. All right, so I'll loosen this. We'll raise the window. I don't have it loose enough, but there. And that's what holds it up, just like that. Doesn't go up all the way. It's not supposed to. It never was designed to, but it goes open enough to, you know, get some air in here. Let's go on the outside and see what this looks like now. And I gotta tell you, these window systems, as complicated as they look, they have turned out to be the easiest part of this whole trailer. Isn't that amazing? And there it is from the outside. Got the screen in, got the window open. It comes up to about here. And then this one over here is the other finished one. And it's closed, so you can see what that looks like when it's closed. And that's all there is to these systems, these window systems. Well, that's it for this video. I basically wanted to show you how different trailers varied in construction over the years, especially these early ones from the 40s. They were still trying to figure it out and get it together. They did get it together by the mid 50s, and from there on, it's trailer history. But here in the 40s, they were still trying to figure it out. They were trying to build nice trailers that were functional and strong enough to hold up on the highway when being drug around on those old roads. A lot of them were dirt back then. A lot of them weren't even paved. So these trailers had to be able to hold up. This trailer is 74 years old, and it's still with us. So I think it's gonna last another 70 years if it's well taken care of. Anyway, that's it for today. I hope you liked this video. If you did, why don't you go ahead and like it? Give me a thumbs up, because that really helps with the YouTube stuff. And go ahead and subscribe if you haven't done so already. I've got well over 900 videos out public videos up on the internet here on YouTube to show you how all these different trailers are built and put together so that you can restore your trailer to be safe and beautiful on the road. I'm Larry, Mobile Tech from CanhamTrailers.com. We'll see you all next time, folks. Have a good one. Well, that's just real nice looking, isn't it? Yep, they're all real nice looking. Just about done with this trailer.